but we can speak now to the Ukrainian ambassador to the European Union, and his name is Kostyan Yeliseliev. You're very welcome to the programme, Ambassador. First, a bit of a response to some of what the General said there. These are going to be the first seven NATO flags in Eastern Europe. How does that make you feel?
First of all, thank you very much and good morning to you. Yes, indeed, currently Ukraine is terrorizing by our big neighbor, which is Russian Federation, and we are deeply need and we expect a kind of military support from our partner countries, in particular from the NATO member states and from the countries of the European Union.
You expect it?
Yes, because the situation is following that Russian-backed terrorists, they continue shelling Ukrainian cities and villages, and by aggravating the humanitarian situation, they targeting civilian population, and they are using the most sophisticated weaponry and armament which was brought from the territory of the Russian Federation. And could you imagine, you are in the apartment which consists of 29 rooms, and one of your room would like to be some bandits would like to grab. So that's why, in order to help to your partner, you need to provide kind of assistance, not only non-lethal one.
Well, with this, of course, it brings up so many issues. I will say that Russia continue to say that they do not back the rebels in eastern Ukraine. But this escalation, are you not concerned with NATO forces in the area that it might prompt Russia in a way to push back in a way that they're not at the moment?
First of all, there are a lot of evidences that indeed Russia continues supply of weaponry, armament and regular forces to the territory of Ukraine. As of today, there are around 8,000 Russian well-equipped soldiers on the territory of Ukraine. These facts are undeniable.
Although they are denied by Russia, I do just have to put that in there, but continue.
Yes, and secondly, of course, we are interested to get military support mainly from at the bilateral basis from our partner countries, in particular from the EU member states. And in the coming days, my president will meet in Munich the NATO Secretary General with a view to discuss it. But once again, we count very much on a bilateral military support to avoid any kind of allegation from the Russian Federation that we would like to bring to Ukraine NATO troops or something like this.
We have been reading that Ukraine needs $5 to $10 million a day to fight the war against the rebels. That would sound like you need money more than you need weapons. What is the EU offering you?
Currently, we are facing, by the way, actually two enemies. One, this is the aggressor country, which is the Russian Federation, and this is external enemy, internal enemy. This is reforms in Ukraine. So we need to deliver on reforms. So, and we need money not in order to save our very difficult both financial and economic situation. We do need money to better explore our huge internal potential. I mean, industrial, agriculture, even human potential. So for this, indeed, we are counting very much on the, in particular, on the EU microfinancial support and support from the International Monetary Fund.
But what have they promised you so far?
As of today, we are in a very constructive dialogue with IMF with a view to launch a new program of cooperation with this financial institution. And secondly, currently EU is considering to provide Ukraine with additional amount of microfinancial assistance. And recently, Brussels took a decision to give to Ukraine 1.8 million, billion, sorry, euro of assistance. But once again, we do need this money again, not to only pay back salaries or social benefits. We need this money to explore huge Ukrainian potential and to make Ukraine stronger. The stronger Ukraine, this is the better reply to Russian aggression.
Well, you've made your thoughts very clear on Russia, indeed, and difficult to get those reforms, no doubt, when this conflict is taking all the headlines and so many resources in the east of the country. That is Ukrainian ambassador to the European Union, Kostyan Yeliseliev.